In this video, I'm going to show you the workflow on how to use the Houdini Engine plugin with Unity. So of course, the first step we're going to do is we need to install our plugin. So here I already have installed it. So if everything is right, you will see it here at the top. To install the plugin, you will have to go to the Houdini files, and there is a folder here called Engine. So double click on Engine. You will see here for Unreal and Unity. So these are the two ones for the game engine, of course. If you're not seeing the Unity or Unreal folders here, that means when you installed Houdini, you did not download these tools. So I'm double click on Unity, and this is a default Unity package. So I can just double click on the package, and then it's going to install. When everything is installed, at the top here, you will see this menu. So now I'm going to go here and find my HDAs that I want to open, and I can just simply drag and drop it in here. And now it will pop up here as well. This asset, I'm going to take it, drag it in the scene. And a few seconds later, you will have our asset. This is here the quick tree asset, so we can draw a curve and the tree will grow around it. Now we can go in the parameters and change as much as you want. If you're then happy with your result, I would like this to be actually baked into an object or a prefab. So in here, we have actually a baking option, so we can click on bake. And then we have this menu here to then bake our objects. So by default, you have game objects, prefabs, keep output only, and update. So a game object is just a Unity game object, nothing more. So a prefab means that they will create a game object and a prefab. Keep output only basically means that we will just delete the script and we will only see an output here in the scene. And we have also here the update button to then update an existing prefabs or game objects. Now the most used setting here that I use is actually just a prefab one. So let's just click prefab. Now it's generating the prefab. And in my scene now I don't see this prefab. So we have to go here to our projects. And there is a Houdini folder normally. So click on that folder, and now we have a option here between baked and working. So I've actually baked a model, so I'm going to go look in baked. And here are all the baked models you have done with Houdini. So here I can see actually the tree that I baked, so tree. And now I see here my prefab, and I've also see here the mesh. So let me just grab that prefab. And as you can see, it's a copy of what I have here. But now it's just a prefab. So what we can do now is I can go back to my digital asset. I can go here into the curve. I can start tweaking this like so. Like I have a different tree. And again, I can just click bake. And now you see here an extra folder called tree 2. And now I have this tree. It can happen here that the material is not right. So let me just quickly assign it here. And now I have a different trees. So this is the way on how you can quickly get generated variations. Is you're just gonna set the parameter and click bake every time you have a version you want to save. That was it for the video. Now you should have a good idea on how to use digital assets and bake out results.